You know, it's quite funny how in the ages where, our minds are most shaped and we absorb everything like a sponge and we can truly unlock some great states for our future adult life, it's also the time where it seems that we're most negatively affected by not so productive parenting and like-minded, peers in school, in particular with bullying and things like that. Like when the mind is most malleable for beliefs, for really setting yourself up to, reach your full potential, we are often limited, like from the get-go.
Yes. This is where it starts. But that's not where it ends.
Just quite interesting if that's people's, if that's people's karma, or if that's just, the pocket of frequency that they've happened to come into. Because it's a common occurrence, right? It's not a rare thing, like especially in the Western world, it's all down from parenting and childhood experiences.
Absolutely. It's extremely common. As a matter of fact, it's the norm.
So, bearing all this in mind, and the heavy traumas that children can go through that they never truly resolve and they carry this baggage into adult life, how would you say, or what would you say is the best way to start changing the language that we use? Because it's easier said than done, especially when you've been repeating it for so long and it is pretty much unconscious to the point of, if you say, if you do something wrong, right, you automatically think or say, oh, I'm so stupid, or, wow, I can't believe I did this, like, I'm so silly. And we know it's detrimental and we know that it affects everything around us, but what would be the best way to start slowly changing those years of unproductive programming?
It starts with looking in that mirror. See, we're, for the most part, too busy running around reacting to reality. We've got to be able to find a way to sit still and analyze our behavior in the moment. When you start to analyze your behavior in the moment, you can start to trace where this behavior was inspired by and where that inspiration came from and where that inspiration came from. We're not looking for why, we're looking for how. And we're looking for what is actually happening. When you can find the structure of how you create your problematic states, these are actually called strategies, by the way, right? People who are able to go into anxiety, who suffer from anxiety a lot, they're extremely skilled at putting themselves into that state. It's a strategy that they use. They see something, they hear something, they think something. And it leads them down a trail and a path of going into a state of anxiety. So if we're able to stop and analyze the steps that lead you to anxiety, so here's the thing, you say that it happens automatically. We talk about these people acting on autopilot, but that's a misnomer. It's a misuse of the word. It's not actually autopilot. It just happens so fast, it's subliminal. It happens below the liminal threshold. It happens so fast that the conscious mind can't pick it up. That's because we've been doing it so much, so well, that the neurological pathway from being okay to being anxious is so strengthened we can get there in the blink of an eye. So if we're able to stop and be in the moment, we can start to become aware of that process as it happens and start to backtrack. Okay, so right now I'm feeling anxious. What made me feel this way? Okay, I saw this. I thought that. I'm having this feeling. Okay, this is leading to this state. Why? Okay, well, because this. You see, so when you start breaking it down like that, what's actually happening is you're disassociating yourself from the emotion instead of just purely experiencing the emotion. Does that make sense?
Yeah, because in a way as well, like as you cleared that up, that's also good news because, unconsciously we do a lot of things, like we breathe, we blink, our heart continues to beat. So it's a good thing that, it's not like that and it can be changed to benefit
Yes.
us. It's not a part of our core genetic makeup, if you will, for survival. It's something that we've adapted over the years, and it can be plucked out like a weed.
Yes, it most certainly can be plucked out like a weed. We are not our behaviors. Our behaviors are just things that we do. What we are is pure energy. But to identify ourselves with a behavior, that would be a grave mistake.
And again, it all goes down to self-concept, right? And your beliefs shaping everything around you, and how important it is to have that strong, solid state and belief in yourself.
Yes.
Interesting.
Yes.
It truly is all connected.